Hey guys, it's me, Vixxeldude3, and welcome back to Planet Coaster. Welcome back to my park. We're going to kick things back into action here. We've made an absolute fortune lately. Just upping that ticket price has been great. It's also kind of held my numbers steady, meaning that I can adapt to it, keep everyone happy, as you can see right there. Our current challenges are to get a balance bonus of 270, which should not be too difficult. Also, you can actually delete challenges as well. Interesting. I guess they eventually get replaced with another one. See, I can't see myself building a 1300 meter coaster for a while. Actually, let's see. So this is a new coaster we built last episode. The underground monster. Yeah, literally underground monster. Now, can I see actually how long? There should be a way to check. Overview. Is there a length stat? Aha, so here we go. Length 703 meters. That's what that looks like. So 1300 is pretty much double that. So I don't think I'm going to do that anytime soon, so I'm going to delete that and see if it gets replaced with another one. The 9 Excitement, we have some interesting stuff for that, and we may give that an attempt shortly. Actually, if I close this all down, let's see, did I research anything extra while I was waiting? So, okay, there we go, Titan version. Ooh, okay, so yeah, we can do a lot with that coaster, the Boa. The Boa indeed. So what else do we want to research? May as well get another coaster going, we've got plenty of money, I may as well have 3 researchers going. Let's get another thrill ride. And should we get a track ride? No, let's get another family ride in here. There we go, we're researching at maximum efficiency. But now let's get this functioning and ready to go. So, we're going to have the entrance path here, and we're just going to have it link down to here. The only thing I wonder about is that going to kind of annoy people? No, I think it's fine. I think that's fine. Pathways, let's get some queue in here. Some QQ every Tim. Now, I think we're going to need to get quite a long queue in here. So I'm going to make it all kind of nice and tightly packed in this area. Just got to remember that we do need to get the exit path in here as well. Actually, may even be easier to go around this way a bit and then come back around once more. Because I just realized I need to also kind of get this pathway downwards. So here we go, and now let's start dropping it down. And yeah, this should do the job quite nicely here, and it's allowing it to curve quite nicely around that edge there. And we should make landfall just about. There we go, that's nice. And now we're gonna connect the pathway for the exit. Cheers, oh wait, place exit. Here we go. Have that straight there so people come straight off the ride, straight into the exit. Something important to keep an eye on. And then again, we're just going to have this just curve its way down and round. I wonder if it would be a smart move to actually put like facilities, like food places and stuff, on the, imagine putting them on the bottom, on like the exit path of the ride. That could be interesting. Now, before I open this up, I want to get the scenery going. So this is all ready to open up, I believe. Where do you actually see? Yeah, it's got 2 cars, it's doing good. But you can see its prestige is not that good, because it's gone actually up since I put in the entrance and exit. I mean, I guess that makes sense. We need to get some scenery to make this all a bit better. So that involves going into ZK. It's got 30% queue scenery. Really? What on earth could that be from? I guess this stuff must be in range down here, which is pretty good. But we need some of our own stuff, and this is a little daunting. Gonna dive straight into it. I think that's a good queue length. It's a nice little exit path. Creates actually a cool little kind of secluded area there, which is all good. So we need to start doing its scenery. Scenery indeed Z. Okay. Now, you can actually, there is a way to like go in. Yeah, so we can actually get into these tunnels. And actually, yeah, if I keep pushing forward, look, I'm in the tunnel here. Thing is, we're gonna have to do, what we're gonna do. I mean, like, start off. Okay, they're going into the ground there. Look, that just doesn't look that great. A lot of people said kind of put rocks around the outside to make it look more natural. I do have some new schematic things. I have some cave entrances that hopefully some of them will fit here. I think they're not really designed for this kind of stuff. Skull cave entrance. Okay, so now that's the entrance to a ride or a pathway. But I could kind of make that work. I really think I could. If I just took out that middle section, but obviously that's going right through the middle of the ride. I'd have to take out the middle section, but this skull is kind of main feature there, so we won't be doing that. This tropical decoration could go underground somewhere. I definitely do have, let's see, it should kind of come under cave. Okay, lit cave entrance, yes, that looks pretty good. Now it's just a case of getting it in the right place. And if we submerge it a bit, now it's not being very, there we go. We could have this built in like this. It's just about fitting it in the right place. I want to see how this looks. You know what? It's very cool, but I feel like that amount of foliage, without there being kind of more foresty stuff, does look a bit weird, is the only thing I'm thinking now on the offset. Also, do I like that gap there? Not particularly. I mean, I could like select a section of it. I could like enclose it. I could have like a tree line going down here as well. I like the way that looks. I'm just thinking, is that the place for it? It kind of matches this, which is quite nice. What I could also do is try and get the multi-tool selection here. We just want to get like this bit here. And we want to, how do I duplicate this? So I don't want to move it, advanced move selection. No, I want to, where is the duplicate? Okay, there is no duplicate option here. See if I have anything that works. Similar way, I think that's quite a unique little style. I also definitely want to get some, I'm just going to get some rocks to fill in this little back section here. Right, we want to go for the large rocks. Here we go. Just slam that in there and there. There we go, that does the job. And let's get one there. How does that look on the inside? On the inside, I think that's quite cool the way it has a little bit of lighting, it drops in. Probably gonna continue bringing these in. So again, like, why are you not letting me copy this? I just wanna copy this item. Oh, there we go, duplicate. Okay, so cool. So we can get some lighting in here. I think that's a lantern section in here will be nice. Ugh, so claustrophobic working down here. Trigger duration. I think I just wanna leave it on, right? Seems like they do more light out here than they do in there. But let's duplicate this now. Seems like actually it kind of spreads out from them. As if I always need to have them, these lanterns floating. Because look, if I stick them on the roof, looks like they lose a lot of their lighting. Ugh. I could put one under. Can I put some under the ride? Let's see. Or let's just get it on the roof. Let's see, we have it up there. See, why is that? Oh no, that one is lighting it up, I think. Oh my goodness, it's tough going through here. Okay, you know what we can actually do? We can have a look at how that looks now. Ride camera, actually I need to play. That doesn't really add any lighting at all. I think it's because of where they're placed, because you can see it was adding some lighting at one point. All right, can we get in there again? Excuse me, game, I would like to go in the tunnel. Oh, they never said it was gonna be easy. This is why I avoided tunneling. Oh, how have I ended up here? What the heck? Save me. This is why it's difficult. Maybe we, and the thing is, I wanna mess around with terrain in there. Like, could I make this bigger? I probably could if I just got in. Got a nice angle. Push ourselves in a bit more. Don't kick me out. Oh, okay, we're in. If I made this a bit more spacious, I'd probably have an easier time here. Okay. This seems to be good. Again, we don't want to be expanding it upwards. Okay, you can literally like tunnel with this tool, which is quite good. I'm trying to give myself some more space under here. Got to be careful though. You don't want to, okay, I need to get rid of these now. Ruined it, but I've got a bit more space here. I'm thinking maybe I could add like a little lake towards one side. What's the deal with water in here? It's not going to let me add water, is it, at this height, because it's going to intersect with the ride. So we are just going to, yeah, we're just going to go with scenery. Going to go with lights. Where is lighting? Props. Lights, here we go. Colorful event lights, lanterns, got standing lanterns. Almost want to go with the spotlights, to be honest. It's actually quite hard to light these. You know, I think the spotlight's the best way to actually get light in. We could have some of these facing in to kind of like cast some shadows. So one there, rotate one in, place it in there. Is that on? Well, it doesn't look like you're on, right? And it's just not, this is not easy working conditions. Ugh. I wanna grab the light, please. Here we go. Light. Oh, see, yeah, if the slightest tip of it intersects with the wall, it's not gonna light up. You need to have it. Wait, what's happened to it now? Why do you not work? So let's copy it from this side and let's try it. In fact, oh, this is tough. This is tough stuff right here. Honestly, I think I may just take the time myself to do all this underground decorating because I think it's gonna be really annoying to get done just because of the way the mountains are. I'm just gonna get it done myself and I'll show you guys what it looks like when it's done. Okay, doing this kind of stuff is a nightmare. You have to throw in literally this much light to even see what you're doing. So what do we have? So basically, this section here, I thought, you know what, the paths go underground at the same point. Let's link them together. I tried the same here and I couldn't even get the camera angle right. But yeah, if you come in here now, and even let me, that's like half of the struggle is just getting the camera to even go in there. All right, here we go, let's aim up properly. We're going here. Come on, please, please. I just want to go and see my underground bit. Like, there's definitely better ways to kind of manage the camera and everything to do this kind of stuff. I'm just not that advanced yet. We should, really? See, this is what I'm working with. And now it's like, my camera doesn't even know where it is. It's like stuck to the floor. No, we just want to go, literally. Oh my, okay, you know what? Let's try and enter from here. This section is pretty open up. Okay, we're in. Okay, perfect. So this is the space I have to work with. And like, even just seeing where I was kind of clearing dirt was almost impossible, but we have this little space. Let's make this look nice, bump up some scenery, some underground coolness. I mean, the lights are all pretty good. I think I'm gonna move this big lantern to the very middle point now. I'm wondering, will it let me actually add water in here? Ooh, see that? It can't go any higher than that, I think, because the rise. Oh no, see, that's pretty cool, I'd say. And now what I can even do is I can grab this and move it up so it's out of the water. So it like illuminates it. Is that a thing? Or does it just give up on lighting once it's, really? I guess just the water's too dark for it even to light up. Okay, we could put some of these either side of the water, couldn't we? Have like one there. Then we duplicate one, two, there. And then we also duplicate another, put it there. Look at me, I'm a decorational master. Now let's leave that there. Now let's get one more on this little edge of the, where does the water even, that is a good question. There we go, I mean, people are gonna come past here very fast. That's my excuse for it not looking so good. I'm like, yeah, they're barely gonna see it. I want these to look more embedded. Gotta sometimes pay attention to the finer details. These things. See, that's actually in the water there. And it's really in the rock there. It's not a good spot for it there. That'll do. Okay, so now I'm thinking a spotlight on the roof, which is not going to be easy to do. Camera angle, please. Okay. See. Oh, this is good. This is looking good. We're underwater scenery. Spotlight. Okay, now I want you. I want you just up there. Now we're going to place you. Grab you and use some advanced rotations. Here we go. Perfect. Aha. Is that looking good? Is that pointing right in the middle of the water? I don't even know. Oh no. Whoop. Okay, where am I right now? No. Stay me underground. Oh, this is just so damn awkward. But yeah, I think that's good. That lights it up a little bit more. I almost want to put some more of those in, but we all know that's easier said than done. Look, duplicate, please just state yes. It stays in the same orientation. Okay, that's good. Just tell no one to look at the roof because these probably look like a massive mess. Can I get a steeper angle? Well, look at me 360 in. All right, nice. Just have them placed across like that. And now I got up to here and they look pretty derpy. So now we're gonna move you up to here and up. No, wait, you wanna go further back? I can't, my spatial awareness is just gone right now. Right, I think that's just about in line. It'll do, oh boy. Okay, okay. Camera, stay calm, remain calm. This ain't easy, they never said it was gonna be easy. All right, cool, we're in here, let's get some scenery in here. What can we fit? Let's go on blueprints. Is there anything that fits from here? Any of their custom stuff? You got any cave features? I mean, foliage really has to fit well. I don't think any of it will. There is actually, oh, if I go on scenery, if I go skull. Here we go, that is its own piece, isn't it? It's quite big as well. I'm thinking if I can put one on a wall. That could look quite good. And here we go, the creepy rock skull. It does come with palm trees, which is fine. Oh, see that does actually, and it has lighting in the eyes. That does look pretty epic, actually. Kind of wish I hadn't put those lanterns in. To be fair, I just obstruct one entirely. Look at that, that's actually pretty good. I like that, and you'll see that from that side as you come through. Now let's put another on the other side. And while we do all of this, we're just off in the scenery like mad. Those lanterns were a bit of an oversight, but they do add a lot of light. Oversight, but they add light. Which is fine, we can have them just like stuck in these skulls. That one actually fits a bit better like that. And I can even angle it towards the people coming down that way. Okay, perfect. Well, we've added a little waterhole cave thing. The way this is, I put these in literally just to light the area, and now I feel like they all of a sudden need to have some sort of symmetrical layout. So we'll put one, we put them underwater though. I feel like they lose a lot of their light if they're underwater, so. Have one there, and let's move this one if I can grab it. Move it over here, rotate it this way. Oh! I'm glad I've got everything paused right now, because my park would probably fall apart if I did this any other way. Move you higher up the water scene. Point that way. Same with you. Move up to here and angle that way. I don't even know where this is anymore. That seems about right. Okay, cool. Well, we have a little underwater cave lake thing with some skulls in it and some lanterns. There we go. Now we just have more stuff to do, because this whole area, yeah, it doesn't look like it has much to it. One thing I did do is I continued all these trees around. I made like a little kind of surround of trees. I really should do something with the entrance. I should make that. That would be so cool if I made it its own cave. But it would just take so long. It would take me like an hour of just placing rocks around there to even make that thing into a cave. So, I'm gonna forget that. What kind of decoration? I need like big decoration in here. Like, I don't even know. It's tempting to make the whole thing underground now, but I want to give people a glimpse of light. Okay, blueprints. I can't even talk. All right, that's it. We're getting a crazy caterpillar in here. I have space to fill. It's just, he just doesn't fit. Poor crazy caterpillar. You know, I think it's time to get a lot of this big jungle scenery now. Like the big waterfalls and stuff. Even though, does it even fit? Things, this ground again is so bumpy, and look, this stuff is designed to be placed on the flat. Tis a big problem. Tis a big problem. I wish I could just like download just like a nature pack. I could get the two towers, but this is actually really difficult to decor for. Really is difficult. Like a fountain strip, again, would work on the flat. It's almost something like I want to place in beneath all of this. I wonder if I could fit it in there. What is that intersecting with? I can actually place it down there. Can I? The game shouts no when you can't place it. I could, no, that's intersecting. Oh boy, my creative flow is losing its go right here. I think I may just, you know, it's just gonna take a while, I think, to decorate this whole thing up. I'm just gonna take my time over it, and once it's done, I'll hit you guys up, I think. So we're making progress. I would say making this stuff look good is just really time consuming. So I've added this kind of little rock sculpture with the skull around this end section. And you know what? It looks really, really nice. I'd say anyway. One thing I want to try out is I want to see if I can give him red eyes. Let's see if this works. You know what? Actually, rather than getting lights, just putting in these spheres like this actually makes him look pretty darn sinister. Check that out. It's like, what you're looking at? And now actually, even if I go extra small, and I could get some pupils in here. So here, let's get this. Now let's, oh, see, this is gonna be the hard bit, getting it right at the front. There we go. Boom, one on there like that. He almost looks more sarcastic than anything else. There we go. Check that out, like the creativity you can get with this game. He looks kind of more cartoony, which is fine. There we go. We got a Skull Man. Iron people out, and on the 3D scheme, looks like his eyes are about to explode, but there we go, cool little features like that. I think I may just have to do a rock layout like this for all of these little sections. It's probably going to take me a good, like, 20 minutes to do, but it does really add to the feel of it, and I added this little kind of light topiary thing here with the flower lamps in it as well, so that should look pretty nice, but yeah, I'm going to get to work with this. And there we go, we are done. Rock entrances around every section. I think that really does add a huge amount, just how they look. They don't look like holes in the earth, they look like kind of you've rock blasted out a route through. I've got this little Aztec section here with some like little things. Yeah, some little things. Exactly what they are. Got this nice little linked up section with the topiary and all that sort of stuff. And then you've got the curve with the evil looking dude. I think it is time to, first of all, take a look down here. I should also add some stuff for the queue, actually. I'm trying to think what might be fitting. Kind of give some a taste of what's coming up. I'm probably going to go into my blueprints and see if I've got anything. I've already got Aztec on the rocks. To be fair, though, I might just drop one in here just as like a... I think that fits quite nicely in that little space. Let's have that facing out like that. There we go. That's going to add some nice queue scenery. Even the Aztec art, I might even fit in behind. Why not, hey? Why not? It all suits the theme, as it were. There we go, and you'll see that as you're coming around on that final approach. So that's more ride scenery. Anything else you want to add down in here before we give this thing another test run? Which I'm super excited for. Can I fit any of these in here? Not really. Just looking for little things. Why not have like a little fairy well there? Why not? Just fill space up a little bit. Get some stats up. Have a little nice archway that will not fit there, but will fit in here, actually, if I just tweak it a little bit. You know, if I actually have it flat, horizontal there, fits like that. There we go. That's pretty cool, and it kind of goes into the scaffolding, but that's fine. What other little things can we add here? Just looking for those little things. Nice little jungle lamp there, why not? Just trying to make everything look that a little bit nicer, that little extra bit. And I got some new fountain runs, didn't I? Oh, to be fair, actually, I could probably fit one of these in here as well. This would have saved me so much time had I thought of this sooner. To be fair, have I got a low loop that's missing? Yeah, we could drop it in here if... Whoa. I'm looking to drop it in here. Let's rotate that. This was honestly a great time to practice. Yeah, that looks really good, actually. A great excuse to practice my kind of pathing skills with this stuff. Look at that. That's really good, actually. That adds a lot to everything, I think. Boom. It is in. Nice. So I've kind of utilized all of this space. But we could have some, like, pathways through here, some shops and stuff down the line. I'm thinking perhaps if I extend it off this way, perhaps one day. I don't know. We could work something out. But, my friends, it's time to see what that did to the prestige. It better be better. Okay. So, this is literally, I've spent an hour. Oh my goodness, an hour doing scenery. Lovely. Lovely stuff. Right, well, let's hit playtime. Let's close it. Let's test it. Let's start testing. How do I run the test? Okay, it's going. Here we go. Let's jump on. I'm liking this. Coming under. We've got a bit of lighting in here. Yeah, see, it looks, those exits look way, way better now. We're going up the chain lift section. You actually come into the chain lift pretty damn fast. Like, you get pretty high pretty quickly. And now we're going back into the earth. Got a little bit of just lighting. You're escaping again. Going back under. Yeah, that scenery's looking good. You kind of catch a glimpse of that guy. Coming back under again. You get a look at that scenery. Coming out. Back under. Out again. Under. Over through the arch. Under and around. And you get to see some splashes from the log flume, and you're back at home, and she's happy as anything. Okay, prestige, your boy, 1K. Let's open it up. Boom, it is ready. Now watch the hordes commence. Look at that. I think I've done a pretty good job there. It took absolutely ages. Okay, let's see, my notifications are all looking quite good. New challenge available. Okay, it's just gonna bring it back. Can I get rid of it? I don't even know. Okay, let's see if people... Oh, see, look. And they're gonna start using all of these shops and things more as they head onto this ride. They're going for it. Yeah, they've seen the prestige go up. Things are looking good. Heart store still causing chaos. Let's have a look at park flow. Looking really quite good right now. What's the prestige saying over here? This is really good prestige. I'm tempted just to spam a load of scenery down. See what that does here. I mean, that's a ton of scenery. Seeing if that could be an option here. Let's literally just... I mean, I've got so much money, right? I spent 4 grand on scenery, actually, at the other place. That is pretty crazy. What should we go for? What shall we go for here? Planet Coaster. There we go. A nice little... I feel like that fits nicely into the side of that mountain there. Maybe if I have it more on the floor kind of thing. I have it like that. There we go. Just to add that in there. I don't think I'm going to have anything else there at any point. Maybe a pathway coming down here and doing some more stuff over here at some point. But that's fine by me. Have that there. We've got... You know what? Let's put a geyser at the top of this mountain as well. I know it's not the same ride, but... There we go. Why not? Go for that. Okay, what do we have here? We have shipwrecks, tree collections, UFOs. It's got my blueprints. Anything I can add in here? It's a little bit unique. A little bit funky. Flowery fountain strip. That's more something I'd put down a pathway, I feel like. Jungle ruined tower. Where will this kind of fit? I'm always thinking if I could have it. I might just wrap it in just around here. Just as a bit of scenery as they come out of the mountain. Got to get that floor height right. There we go. Just a little extra added something. And again, this is going to get updated. Yeah, there isn't much scenery around this ride at all, to be honest. So the more the better. That's the main bit of scenery. It's just that archway. What if I just add a shop here as well? What if I just add, like, jungle loony balloons? Literally just under here. It's going to add scenery, and it could potentially attract some people around here. I don't think I have a balloon shop, so That's a little change there. I don't know if that's gone up at all. Let's see, is this... This is doing fine. Everything's doing just fine, really. Let's check up on our staff here. And let's see, all staff. Okay, anyone with workload high? Just train him up. Get him up to 255. That's what I'm looking for. Anyone with high workload. Let's train you up and get you on 175. Train you up, get you up to 190. Train you up, get you to 180. Could I train up? There we go. And that, look, you see their workload becomes more manageable. And this means you can serve more people, less people in queues. You're just not happy, are you? Fired. You, fired. You're in the fixable range. Get you up there. Same with you. Keep an eye on this. Didn't even have much workload, but we'll give him the promo. Oh, yeah. Get you up and about. I'm just... The wages aren't fair anymore, I agree. I'm just doing it randomly, as anything. So now I'm going to need to hire someone new for the person I hired. So let's go on attractions and shops. Let's go shops. Let's go to... See, okay. Roctopus, open it up. Why is it testing? Open it up. Why is it testing? So there'll be just those two that are closed. Now they're opening again. We completed the challenge. I assume that was the balance. Yeah, boy. Easy money. Nice. Nice stuff. Population is staying the same, but actually, I haven't really done much this episode. Let's see. Are people hopping on here? Okay, this is slightly worrying. Let's just assume they're still making their way. I mean, it has great stats. Look at it. Great stats. Keep it up. Looks too intense for me. 1%. What's the other thing I want to do? I want to... Oh, wait, no, it just did a run with two people on it, but I'm sure they loved it. Look at that. Made some great money this month. Everything's looking all right down here. Is this getting many people yet? Not really. I think it did just open, though, in all honesty. Okay, let's see. See, overview. Guests are pretty happy. It's like people want another flume. Ooh, someone stepped in sick. Okay. Let's get another janitor. Do we need another janitor? Honestly, maybe we don't. It's like, where do we go next from here? Everything's just kind of ticking along nicely. Let's see. I might actually get a rapids ride. That's something I might do next episode. That is something I might do. Any of these looking new and fresh? Thing is, like, sometimes people want a ride that's pretty chilled out. Like, let's get a new gentle ride. What is an exciting gentle ride? The Whirly Rig. This thing's tiny, to be fair. Let's get it placed in. Where do we want this? People are slowly making it out that way. I've just got to hope that in good time, it will pick up. I mean, definitely there's more people on this pathway than there ever have been before, which is good. Like, honestly, we could just place this in here. I think just at this point, honestly, more stuff is going to be helpful as well. All right, let's place the exit here. Let's have that loop straight up. The more stuff, the better. Let's just run this alongside. How long do you want the queue to be? That's about right. Give people the option down there. All right, let's open it up. And that'll bring different groups of people out this way. Let's get some scenery in there. I've got that real nice fountain thing. Let's see. Fountain. So we want the flowery fountain. No, is that a tongue twister? Probably not. That's actually a little too big to fit in. And then this is even bigger. So we may have to go back for this standard, if in doubt. Where is it? There is a perf. There's the perf. Yeah, it's the little one I used before. I'm trying to think. I've used a lot of this stuff before, honestly. Could get a nice little rock garden. Again, it doesn't fit. We need some really slimline stuff. Slimline stuff. Just get a small drink shop. I think that's a new schematic. Here we go. No, I don't want to do that, actually. Grab Zed, sorry. There we go. That actually makes the path wider. And it adds some decent scenery as well. Let's throw that in. There. Now let's see what the queue scenery is saying down here. Overview. Yeah, I got it up to 90%. Actually, this stuff probably helps as well. This stuff probably helps. Tree for path. There we go. Let's get a few of these down here. Now we're at 100. 100%. Perfection. Just want to double check this. Yeah, this must be at 100%. Overview. Yeah, 100%. And it's getting there now. It's starting to get there, which is good news. And again, it's just going to attract people out this way. Steal some competition from there. Everything's looking pretty good. 4.5k on the expensive ticket price. Ratings. There we go. 3,300. Interestingly, queues aren't amazing for this right now. Which is worth considering, even though there's a lot of footfall. And its prestige is still really up there. Not sure what that's about. I almost want to put eyes in this dude as well. Should I do it? We'll do that another time. We'll do that another time. But yeah, everything's running nicely. What's the prestige on here? 520. This park is a bargain. Entry's cheap. And Sunflare 1 is cheap. That's good to know. Let's actually check out more guest thoughts. Let's see what leaving guests think. Okay. Ratio's dropped a little bit, but that's just, I feel like, inevitable with the amount of people getting in here. Actually, that's come up a little bit. You know, I think it's the water places. I think we need more water places, like water drink places. This is all being used a lot more now. Which is good. I think I'm going to swing around here. And we have actually, is this a water store? No, Chief Beef. Street Fox Coffee. Let's throw in some water up here. The hat shop thing has been patched. Let's go on drink shops. Do I have anything custom? To be fair, I do have a new blueprint for a shopping area. I might just use it. My blueprints. It was the Aztec one, wasn't it? Aztec. No, I imagine that. Shop. Let's see, shop. Lost Temple with shops. How many shops does it have, though? Looks very cool. See, I think it only has, like, a toilet. Has a toilet and one food place. As cool as it is, that's a nope in my book. A Western drink shop just doesn't really fit here, does it? I don't know. Actually, we could just tuck it in. There, we can get the path to connect up properly. Nope. Where do we want it to be? Yeah, we want it. You know, that's it. We're going to custom. Shops and facilities. Custom drink shops. Pip shop water. And let's just hook it into this little section here. Get it its own nice little queue. See, why does it not like connecting? Connect with us. There we go. Boom. Got it. And I might just leave it as is, to be honest. We could just give it some custom scenery. Just put some random clay pots around, because that seems like a great idea, doesn't it? Don't ask. They're like water pots. Sure. Whatever you think. Whatever you say. You know, people have been telling me to get a Kraken tag for ages. Look how freaking huge that is. That thing is mental. Would that... Loads of people told me to put it in this lake once upon a time. That's just ridiculously sized. Kind of a park you think we're running here? No. We'll leave that like that. But all in all, I think things are looking, again, pretty great. I'm pretty happy with how this went out. I'm just giving it time before it gets popular. Surely it must do. Yeah, people are slowly flowing. And once I get more people in this area, it'll be good. Look, this ride's getting decent popularity. Which is good. I'd say on all fronts, we're doing pretty good. And we're at a record number of guests. 4.7k, and look at the money we're making. Like, that has to be a good sign. We're making money stupidly fast. I'm not even in fast forwarded, and like, we are just making money. Like, I have cash to do anything, really. Like, I could make food and drink free in my park. I can make it complimentary and still make really good profit. So that is a good sign. One final thing we're going to do with this episode before we wrap up is I want to see what it looks like riding this ride now with everything around. Someone said I should do an episode where I ride every ride in my park, and I would be hella down. But here we go. Let's see. So we're going off. Look at this. This is so cool. Like, this is me. This is my park right here. And this is going to be the final offering today. Sorry, I guess in the content side, it's a bit shorter because I did spend literally 40 minutes doing scenery. Let me know if you enjoyed me doing that, though, and your thoughts on that sort of stuff. As opposed to everything else. Look at this. You just get to see sights and sounds from all around. You actually feel like you're in the middle of like the serious hub. And I like it, that's what I was going for. Again, apologies for the frame rate. Look how much stuff it's rendering. Look how much darn stuff is being rendered right now. So darn cool. And look at that, and you're back in. And you're set. Actually, one thing I did just spot while riding my ride that loads of people told me about, they said apparently this hill is too steep for people to go up and use those shops. I mean, I don't know how... I mean, realistically, look, these are just losing money. Let's see. Look, it's just losing money. Customers 0, 2. Customers 2. There were 2 people that made it up the hill and 1. This is the biggest fail ever. So, it is time for it to go, my friends. Thing is, that's going to select the ride, actually. Have to do it vertically. And let's delete. There we go. It is done. Goodbye to this area. It was a valiant effort and idea, but it is now gone. It is all gone. Let's get off the pathing. Delete that. And... we're looking pretty darn good. I just want to, you know, I'll leave that section open for now. It is what it is. But yeah, the flow's actually really working quite well right now. All around the place. I just want to see this queue get full. That's all I want to see. Maybe with 2 trains going, it's a problem. I don't know. It's half filling every time. It's fine. Right. We are going to wrap up there. Thank you all for watching. The Underground Monster is now set up and good to go. Let me just check, see how the stats are looking. So yeah, its stats... oh my goodness, its excitement has gone up? It has. That must be to do with the scenery, I guess. That's pretty cool, because yeah, it was like 7.9, wasn't it? Or maybe I imagined that, I don't know. But everything looking good, looking nice. That 9 excitement coaster awaits me in the next episode. I'll see you all then. Thanks, and goodbye.